Welcome, friends. We will continue applications of differentiation. In that, we are discussing about Jacobians. In Jacobian, we will learn now new technique how to find out partial derivative by using Jacobian. In this lecture, we are going to discuss how to find partial derivative by using Jacobian. Now here I will discuss about to find partial derivative, and we are knowing how to find partial derivatives of every function with respect to x, with respect to y, and so on. But here we will discuss new thing, and we will find partial derivative by using Jacobian. Now, in this case, we are considering here implicit functions. Suppose uv, xy, two functions are given uv in terms of xy or xy in terms of uv, then we are combined by using implicit function f1 equal to 0 and f2 equal to 0. Then, we find here Jacobian of this, and using this Jacobian, we will try to find out partial derivatives. That is w by double x, w by double y, w by double x, and so on. All these derivatives. For that, we need one formula, and we'll write formula. But again, remember that how to write this formula. Directly, I am discussing about to write formula. Here we have two implicit functions, f1 equal to 0 and f2 equal to 0. And we have to find out partial derivative of u with respect to x. Then, first of all, I will write here denominator. And here, to find out partial derivative of u with respect to x. And here, in numerator u is there and in numerator x is there. And we have to write Jacobian formula in this way. We will write here numerator and denominator. First of all, I will write denominator. This is Jacobian of f1, f2. And here this is u, therefore I will write here one pair uv, and I will take here Jacobian of f1 f2 with respect to uv. Now here this uv, we have to differentiate this u with respect to x. Therefore I will make a change in this u in numerator, and here in this Jacobian I am replacing u by x, and I am keeping this v as it is. Remember this, how to write this partial derivative of u with respect to x is equal to minus numerator divided by this denominator. And how to write this numerator and denominator? First of all, write down denominator. This is in terms of uv, because first pair is uv is given, therefore this is uv. And we have to find partial derivative of u with respect to x, therefore I am making change in u by x. And I am keeping here. In similar way, we will write this formula, double v by double y. Since we have to find partial derivative of v with respect to y, and we have pairs uv one pair and xy another pair. Therefore, here is from this uv pair. Therefore, in denominator, I will write Jacobian of f1 f2 with respect to uv. And I will write here Jacobian of f1 f2 with respect to uv and Jacobian of f1 f2 with respect to uy. How to write? First of all, write on denominator. This is v, therefore I will write here uv, v, and numerator containing this u I am keeping as it is now. We have to replace this v by y. I am replacing v by y. Again, we will try to write new formula. Jacobian of here partial derivative of x with respect to u. Again, here this is x, therefore this is in the pair of xy. Therefore, I am taking first of all this Jacobian. In numerator, only we have to replace this x by u, and I am keeping y as well. Okay, in this way we will write here formula. And again, here we will write remaining results also, partial derivative of y with respect to u. U, partial derivative of y with respect to v again, and so on. Now I will consider three functions, three implicit functions, f1 equal to 0, f2 equal to 0 and f3 equal to 0. In this we have pair uvw and xyz. This is pair uvw, xyz. Now how to write our derivatives? To write derivatives, now we have to write here Jacobian f1, f2, f3 with respect to this, either this pair or this pair. Now we write this formula. Partial derivative u with respect to x is, now again here is u, that means this is in a pair of u v w, therefore I am taking Jacobian of u v w, what is Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to u v w, and we have to differentiate this u with respect to x, therefore I am making change in u and replacing u by x and keeping remaining terms. In similar way, we will write next formula. Partial derivative v with respect to y, then how to write? Here is v, therefore in denominator we have to write Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to u v w and make a change of v with respect to y and remaining terms u as it is, v as it is, w as it is. Okay, again we will write here newly, and you can also try to write remaining results, partial derivative of h with respect to u. This result again we write here minus sign. This is x, therefore I am taking pair of xyz and this x replacing by u, keeping remaining terms. Again we are learning how to write this formula. This is the Jacobian of f1, f2 with respect to u, yz, and we are knowing, we are familiar to write this type of Jacobian formula. Okay. Now we will discuss one example. If x is equal to u plus v plus w, y is equal to u square plus v square plus w square, and z equal to u cube plus v cube plus w cube, and find or then show that partial derivative of u with respect to x equal to uv divided by u minus v into u minus w. We will try to find out this partial derivative of u with respect to x. But here we have to find partial derivative by using Jacobian. Now here, by using this given 3 equation, we will try to write 3 implicit functions, f1 from this, f2 and from this we will write f3, and these 3 functions are f1 is equal to u plus v plus w minus x, and you can this left as f2 right as f2 is equal to u square plus v square plus w square minus y, and z and f3 equal to u cube plus v cube plus w cube into z. Then we have to write first of all formula for this partial derivative. How to write this partial derivative? Dou u by dou x and f1, f2, f3, these functions are there. We have to write numerator and denominator. Surely we are knowing that denominator containing Jacobian of f1, f2, f3 with respect to here, this numerator u, v, w. And in numerator, we have to make a change. This u we are replacing by x, and remaining terms we are replacing with x. Therefore, this formula here. This formula is correct, but we have to write here dava u by dava x. This is dava u by dava x. My mistake is here, dava v by dava y is there, but this is dava u by dava x. Formula is correct. Now here we have to write u v w and we are replacing u by x. And remaining terms we are keeping as it is. This is equal to this Jacobian divided by second Jacobian. Numerator divided by denominator. What is this Jacobian? This is partial derivative of f1 with respect to x, v, w. X, v, w. Partial derivative of f2 with respect to x, v, w. Partial derivative of f3 with respect to x, v, w. This is numerator. And denominator is greater than that. Partial derivative of f1 with respect to u, v, w. Partial derivative of f2 with respect to u, v, w. And partial derivative of f3 with respect to u. Again, orally we will find here partial derivative, therefore I am not taking a numerator divided by denominator. Therefore, this is equal to minus, I will find partial derivative. F1 with respect to x is minus 1. F1 with respect to v is 1. F1 with respect to w is 1. F2 with respect to x is 0. F2 with respect to v is 2v. F2 with respect to w is 2w. This is f3 with respect to x, this is 0, f3 with respect to v is 3v squared, f3 with respect to w is 3w square. Now again here denominator determined with that f1 with respect to u is 1, f1 with respect to u is 1, f1 with respect to w is 1, f2 with respect to u is 2u, f2 with respect to v is 2v, and f3 with respect to omega is w is equal to 2w. f3 with respect to u is 3u square, f3 with respect to v is 3v square, and this f3 with respect to w is 2w. Orally we find that, therefore I will write directly this minus sign, because you know I will have to write this in here, this is minus sign, this is numerator to the denominator. Now we have to find out numerator and denominator. Again here I will use property because there we will show that in this way. And here property is that in this second row 2 is common and in third row 3 is common. Therefore I will take 2 and 3 common. Now denominator also from second row 2 is common, from third row 3 is common. And if we are taking 2 common from this second row, 3 common from third row, we are getting 3 into 2 is 6 outside this determinant. From denominator also, from the second row we will take 2 common and from third row we will take 3 common and 3 into 2 is 6, 6 is get cancelled. Now after again here we will take minus common from this column and this minus 1 becomes plus and this becomes 1. Now after this we will perform this operation c2 minus c1 and c3 minus c1. Then we will get this term 0, this term 0 because this c2 minus c1 and c3 minus c1. Now here we will take subtraction this column, subtracting from this column and this column. Therefore, 1 minus 1 becomes 0, 2u minus this 2v minus 2u and 3v square minus 3u square. Here, this becomes 0. This is 2w minus 2 is not there. Now we have already taken 2 common. This w minus 2, w square minus u square. And we will get this determinant, numerator and denominator. Numerator we will find here directly by taking cross multiplication of this because these two elements are 0. Now in denominator, from this row, from this column, we will take v minus u as common because here v square minus u square, or we will write, we will solve this numerator by finding determinant. And here in denominator, here v minus u and here we can write factors v minus u and v plus u. Therefore, we will take v minus u common. Remaining term is v plus u. Here, v square minus u square is minus u square. Therefore, again here, v minus u, v plus u. We will take here v minus w minus u as common. And only remaining term is w plus u. Now, then finding this value of determinant, we will get here v minus v into w, we will take common vw into w minus u. This v minus u, w minus u, and value of this determinant is this multiplication minus this multiplication is equal to, we are getting this. And cancelling this numerator and denominator term, we will get our partial derivative of this function u with respect to x. This is our answer. Now nothing is there, only we have to write formula and using this formula we will find out partial derivative. Now try to find out partial derivative for these functions and show that partial derivative of this function with respect to x, here is also with respect to x and this x with respect to u. Try to write out formula and then solve. When we are writing formula in this case, when Jacobians are very easy, orally we will find Jacobians, values of partial derivatives, and we have to find here determinant. to solve determinants in any manner by using their rules that solve this problem. This completes your Jacobian article. In coming lecture series, we'll discuss about another applications of partial differentiation. Okay, thank you.